Alright, evening everybody. Thanks for visiting my channel. I've got a small stove. I took my other stove, it was quite heavy on my last hot tent. So I want one that I could stick in a backpack. So I've ordered one from 3FUL off AliExpress. So just thought I'd share it with you. It's light enough. I don't know what weight it is exactly until I've weighed it. So started opening up with you so you can all have a look at them, what you get if you buy one. It's just so I can fit it in my backpack, you know, it's a bit lighter. Takes ages to come, I think it's super late. About 3 months. Sure. Quite a while, isn't it? So, but I think it was 3FUL gear. That's who it's from. I don't know the exact retailer, there's a few of them on there. You get a pair of supposedly heat resistant gloves with it. So I'll quickly see what they're like. Wow, must have some small hands over there. Well, they do go on, sort of. They don't feel very heat resistant, they feel like cotton gloves. I don't think I'll use them. Wrapping edge at work. Comes in a nice little bag. Nice and light, but it's, well, I don't know how big it is yet. Oh, mooch. There's a little pocket inside with a spark arrestor. It's come slightly damaged, that, so I'll have to see if I can straighten that out. I think these are for going round the chimney, so the chimney's not going to be much of a diameter there. 60mm diameter of them rings. Looks like a damper. Oh, that's alright, it's not bad. Spring, bit of a spring on it, keep it where it should be. That's the chimney sections, stainless steel. It's one of, it rolls out, I think it's supposed to be 3 metres, and then you have to roll it the other way, but somebody said to me it's really thin, so get a lift with that, so I'm not bothered about it at the moment. That's the body of the stove, as you can see. It doesn't even look like a millimetre thick. So, I don't know what this is for, but let's see if there's any instructions. Here it comes, flat packed, and bubble wrap. It's called a Tribe lightweight wood stove. And there's your instructions, it's just a diagram really. English. Before using, please check the local law permits. Please wear gloves when using and assembling. Well, wear gloves when assembling. So that means there could be some sharp parts. So, on second thoughts, I've only just got back work, so I don't want to cut myself and end up with time off. So, there's the front of it. Little catenary wire as an opening device. Damper, oh, is it? No, that's it. Little damper there. Pull it open. Pull it open. There you go, that's the front of it. Ah, I know what this rod's for now. So, that's the rear of it. Not much really to it. And they look like the feet or legs. Legs. So, presume. That's the top. That's a bit awkward to stick together. You've got to try and get it in between the gap there. Fit this edge into this gap somehow. It's really, really thin stainless, this. So, I don't know how long it's going to last. I won't say it was the easiest thing to assemble. That and a rod. Sorry about this, you can't really see what I'm doing. That was a bit of a ball eight, to be quite honest with you. And you do need to wear gloves, that's for sure. Just gonna light it, hopefully. So we've got a lighter on me, which I should have. Let's light it, see if it improves its rigidity. Fire starters, B&M. B&M Garden. Drawing. It's doing the business. That is really dangerous. That is really dangerous. Whoa. That isn't good. This is really flimsy. The chimney doesn't fix to the base proper. As it's got up, stainless steel's buckling and the chimney's falling towards me. So it's gonna have to have some kind of guy lines on it. I'm propping it up at the moment with a garden fork, which is something, yeah, you know what I'm gonna be doing here. Can see, but all the top here buckled when it got hot and the chimney started falling towards me. So there's nothing on that chimney for guy lines, nothing. So something's gonna have to be designed. Otherwise, it's going to be very unsafe. And I'm not putting in a hot tent without that. Not a chance. I think I'll get some key ring split rings. Put them around one of these. Get some key ring split rings. And I'll put them around the rings that hold the chimney in its form, attach them to that and then attach guy lines, because it's dangerous. And I think this fire is going to have to be pegged down to the ground through these holes in the legs also, so it don't fall over. I won't say it was fantastic. Yeah, already it's misformed, so you can't get the door open. But it is giving some serious heat off. All this bleeding chimney to fall over him. I'll not be able to catch it, that's for sure. Yeah, I think it needs some kind of strengthener inside the top to stop it kinking. It's just not good enough. 140 quid, I wouldn't buy one. If I knew what I knew now, I wouldn't buy it. But I'm not going to write it off yet. If we have to modify it, I'll modify it. I don't want to modify it too much because I don't want it to get too heavy. I'm not happy with it up to now. gonna go over that. It's a good job. It's a good job we had something to hand to catch this chimney, because seriously, that would have gone right over a fell on me. That, sorry about that, would have gone right over a fell on me. That. That's what I'm opening it up with. Sorry. Look at that. Look at the bottom of that. What's this? That's bad. Sorry, but I'm going to have to put camera down. I don't want to end up with a red hot chimney on me. I'll just move this camera out up there. Whoa. That's bad, that. Whoa. I'm going to let it burn out as quick as I can. Let it burn out as quick as I can, and then they're going to rig some kind of stabilisation for that flue. There's no way you can use it like this. No way on earth. It's dangerous. Chimney's dancing about. There's no wind, it's just the heat, you can see it buckling. Sorry about being out of picture, I'm just trying to keep my eye on that so it don't fall on me and film at the same time, if you know what I mean. That is unreal, that. Yep, I think they're a bit shite, these, to be honest. Unless I'm doing something wrong, I don't think so. They should sell it with a lashing kit, because anybody who likes this who hasn't got a clue, like me for instance, just lighting this and everything starts giving way and folding because of the heat, somebody's going to get seriously hurt, aren't they? You know what I mean? So it needs to be supplied with a lashing kit, eye rings or whatever. I just can't say, it'd just be better if you could. Peg the legs to the ground. You're not going to have a ground sheet under it anyway, really. Eye up, guy lines. With all it needs is like split rings for keys. Put it around one of them. And then you've got guy lines. The chimney will be safe. Slightest bit of wind now, this fire will be over. But it does burn well, give it that. I've just left it on a full draft at the moment, I'm just trying to get it burnt out because it needs a retest when it's cooled down and needs to do something else. Can't worry about that. If that were in any wind now, inside your tent, it'd be deadly, man. It'd be all over the place. In fact, I might put two sets of guy lines on, some high up, some middle. You know, set level with your top of your stove jack or something like that. There's no way I'm putting that in my tent like that. Well, this is why what you do to find out, isn't it? Well, that was scary, that. That was scary. I watched Lundy's Outdoor video. This store is a lightweight one. I think he had a few problems with his and he had to do a few mods and this, that and the other. So I'm not going to write it off. Otherwise I'm just throwing my money at Ben. So I'll try and do something to make it a bit more stable. But that's with the carbon monoxide as well with this. It's just holes everywhere. I can see the fire through the chimney base for a start, so smoke's going to escape from there, unless it's drafted up the chimney. You know, that's going to let carbon monoxide out. The door's not a tight fit, that'll let carbon monoxide out. The sides that the actual thin steel body fits into, I can see the fire all the way around then. So it's just places for smoke to escape. So if you're in a tent and the door is shut, it's not good, is it? I'm going to have to do some serious mods on it, I think. Oh yeah, that chimney it's actually dancing about with heat, so must be doing something to the metal, making it harder or more rigid or something. But I'm glad I just did take it backpacking. Wow. I'm glad. Well, I'm off this weekend somewhere, not where. Google Earth it. I've not even decided whether tent or hammock yet, but whatever, Google Earth, see what's about, and then decide what I'm going to take. I'll probably do a recce and all before I set my gear up. Just want somewhere different for a change. I don't want to go to everybody else's beauty spots. Everybody goes to somewhere else. Anyway, I'll leave this video in here because this could be burning for another half an hour yet. So I'm going to leave this video here. Thanks for watching. If you get one of these, just be careful because you could get seriously hurt. Anybody, I wouldn't like to see anybody hurt with something like this. All right,
see you later.